27th of July 2017.
Okay, this is a veterinary educational video to educate dog owners about urinary stones in their dogs, the diagnosis, treatment and care, post-op care, based on three case studies which I will show the way the three owners treated the dogs. So now we will go to the website. Now I have summarized the three cases in this blog. Now the name of the blog is 2010vets.blogspot.sg, and this one should appear on the video, and this is where all the details are there. I will not be talking about the details. I will talk based on the main points. Now the title is Urinary Stone Prevention Diet. Does it work? So there are three case studies. Okay, so I will start with the first case study. It's bladder and kidney stones in one old dog, Shih Tzu, about 11 years old. Now I'll just show the x-rays. You can go there. X-rays of this case now. Now this case, you can see in 2014 October, the dog was x-rayed and actually there were small kidney stones, maybe two or three small ones, and then there's one big bladder stone. So the complaint was that the dog cannot pee because the bladder is blocked. And x-ray shows the big bladder stone here. So this is in October 2014. So the other view which the vet took was to pass a catheter, urine catheter through, and it went through nicely. And you can see the catheter ends here inside the bladder, and the bladder stone is here. Now there are also two kidney stones here. Now the thing is, I noticed this the vet should have pump air into the bladder, 30 ml through here, through the catheter. They pump air in, and then you have seen the whole bladder. The whole bladder will be seen, and whether there are other information like cystitis, the inflamed wall, and it will be most useful. But in this case, the vet just pass a urinary catheter through, unblock, and then take the x-rays. So each vet does his own thing, so I will not comment on it. But the best practice is to suck out the urine through this syringe, suck it out through the urinary catheter, and then pump 30 ml air in, and you can see the whole bladder, including any other stones as well. Okay, so now this is case one, is October 2014. The bladder was blocked. Then I just continued. Then in May 2016, the bladder stone had been removed. So now in May 2016, the owner came again and said that it passed blood at the end of urination. So what's the problem? What's the problem now? So we did an x-ray, and you can see there are more kidney stones, smaller ones. But the thing is that the vet only had one view, the lateral view. He didn't take the ventral dorsal view, so I had to save money for the owner. So so we can't figure out whether the kidney stones are in both kidneys or in one kidney, because the ventral dorsal view is not taken. Now this is in May 2016. The other one, the bladder 2014, the bladder 2 was removed. So now on palpation, there was a small soft lump inside the bladder. Now this case again, the lump was a soft spherical lump, about 5 cm times 4 cm, not painful. Now bladder stones can be palpated, and also bladder lumps. Now whether this is a tumor or not, a bladder tumor or stone, are not an opaque stone, so that means the stone does not show well on x-ray, because there are some stones which cannot be not radio dense, so it cannot be seen. So in this case, you can see the dog has been licking the the prepuce, the foreskin, until it's swollen. Now, there are no other stones. Now, in this case, there's no urinary catheter pass through because of the pain here, so it's probably not done. And so there's no air contrast. So we don't really know whether there is a, this is a tumor or a stone. So in any way, in any case, the dog is given the precision diet and antibiotic and it's okay now. So I will go to the next case. This is case one, a Shih Tzu. And then the case two. Case two, now in case two I will show that this is a miniature schnauzer, male neutered 12 years, and it's been fed precision diet to dissolve or prevent stones. So it was fed right canine urinary SO, and then it came in for some complaint of recently of difficulty in passing urine. Now in this case you can see the urine has been stringed up or sucked out using a stringe. This is a urinary catheter. So when it's sucked out and then the vet pump 30 ml of air into the bladder, and you can see now very clearly this bladder doesn't have any stones, very clear, and also there's no radiodent stones in the kidney area for this miniature schnauzer. Now you can see the air shows a good contrast, and you can see the bladder wall is quite I would say that not thin, it shouldn't be so obvious, but it's obvious it's inflamed. So this dog could have cystitis in this case, and that's why when we pass the catheter through, it was stuck somewhere here. So there might be some small stones or non-radio dense stones. So it was stringed back into the bladder. It's probably a small one. So they can see that the air contrast is very useful, because without the air contrast, you will see a lot of this intestinal. As you can see here, that intestinal lumps, I'll call it, and it will be all dense here, and there's practically nothing can be seen whether there are stones or no stones. So that is a good thing that you pump air to get the contrast, and that should be the best practice. Suck out the urine, pump air in, 30 ml at least, and take the x-ray. So this is the other view. Always take two views. You can see the ventral dorsal view. The air is there as well. The bladder you can see there. Not so obvious, but there's air. So you can see that there's no stones. And you see the kidney. The left and the right kidney, there are no radial dense stones as well. There's a kidney here and there's a kidney here. So that's good, because you always take two views just in case you want to know whether there are any stones in the kidneys, left or right kidney. So the 30 ml of S pump in the bladder and shows no bladders or urethra stones by contrast. Now in this case, the urine was yellow and clear and the pH was 6.5. No blood in the urine, no crystals and no bacteria. So this is probably a case of cystitis, and the owner had fed prevention diet right canine urinary SO quite regularly, and so the pH is acidified. So in this case, no stone to form in this 12-year-old. This schnauzer is about 12-year-old male schnauzer. Now we go to the third case now. In the third case, you can see this is a Shih Tzu, male, 11 years old. Now, the first vet diagnosed urinary stones 1 year ago, but the owner decides not to get any treatment. Now, we don't have the x-ray of the 1 year ago from the other vet, because the owner says that it was a certain vet, and the vet says they don't have it. So now you can see this one, it was taken recently, and you can see two big urethra stones inside the os penis. Now the male dog has a bone in the penis. It's called os penis. Now this os penis is a bony segment of the dog's urinary system. Now you can see two stones there inside the os penis. Okay. Now there are two ways of solving this problem. One way, of course, is to push it back to here and then open up here the urethra and then take out the two stones, and after that you stitch up the urethra. Now the danger is that the urethra stitches might close up and then the urethra will become too narrow and then the dog cannot pee. Or the other way is the dog might pee out here like the female dog. And then the urine will shoot here onto the floor, because the male dog tends to lift up the leg to pee, and normally it pees to the, let's say, to the vertical wall. But because of this urethrostomy, the urine might shoot up onto the floor and the owner may not be happy about it. So the best in this case, and it was done, the vet put in a catheter and syringe the stone back into the bladder, and inside the bladder the stones are removed by opening up the bladder and taking out the two stones. So ultrasound was removed through cystostomy or incision of the bladder. Now this case shows that dietary dissolution of the struvite stone is not possible because the stones are big, and also whether these stones are struvites or not, we don't know because of the history of from the other vet. Now I will go and see this view, ventrodorsal view. You can see it's not very useful. That's why many vets don't take ventrodorsal view. You can see the stones are hidden, are not so obvious here, but they are here actually. Now the ventrodorsal view is meant more to check whether there are any kidney stones or not. As you can see, there are no kidney stones. The left and right, there are no kidney stones. So in summary, there are three cases, and each case is different from the others in management and treatment. Now this summarizes, in this case one, the treatment of course is to go in and take out the stone from the bladder, and also to give the diet to dissolve the kidney stones if it's due to kidney, the struvite stones. Huh? Now in this case it was done, and the owner has not been feeding the special diet regularly, so at one stage he came back again, 2016, for cystitis. Huh? And the possible reason is because the owner has two dogs. One dog may be fed the prescription diet, and the other dog they feed the commercial food. So this shih tzu may be eating the other food, and so it affects the pH. Now let's go to the second case, just to illustrate that the air contrast is still the best. Air contrast, the x-ray of the bladder is still the best to see. The walls are inflamed, and also there are no radiodense stones or any stones or tumors on the walls of the bladder. So always use air contrast, and also two views. Always have two views to show that the kidneys are okay or they have stones as well. So this is the second case. The third case, the summary is that if the urethra stones are too big, there's no point trying the special diet like RSC, right, Canin Urinary S for 1 year, because it doesn't dissolve the stone, and in fact probably the stone come and get lodged into the os penis from the bladder. Probably, I don't know, because we don't have the x-ray 1 year ago. You can also fit Hill's CD. So these two diets only are meant to dissolve smaller struvite stones. Struvite stones, if they are big, you still have to have a surgery to remove them. Okay, this completes the educational video. Thank you.